अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास 7। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर सेकंड चैप्टर कैसी द क्यूरियस। टेक आउट योर बुक्स एंड ओपन पेज नंबर 24। फर्स्ट आई विल रीड द चैप्टर एंड यू लिसन टू मी अटेंटिवली एंड एनालाइज द डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स एंड देन यू विल फाइंड आउट द मीनिंग्स योर सेल्फ। डू दैम इन योर कॉपी नीट एंड क्लीन। थ्रू व्हाट्सएप विल गिव यू द डेट फॉर गेटिंग योर कॉपीज चेक्ड। A big circus had been staying for some week in the town where Bob White lived. It was a fine circus with many performing horses, lions, acrobats, clowns, and two large elephants. Bob loved the circus and he went there whenever he could. It was not only the show, as the circus folk called it, that he enjoyed. He liked nothing better than to go into the great tent behind the ring. Here lived the beautiful horses, each in its own stall, and here too lived the elephants Bongo and Cassie. Come to the next page, page number 25. Bob soon made friends with the elephants. When their keeper saw that Bob was not afraid, underline the word afraid of the animals, and that he had no wish to tease them, he was always pleased to allow the boy to wander about, underline the word wander about, the tent. Bongo, the old elephant, learned to know Bob in a very short time. But it was Cassie, the other elephant, who became his best friend. Cassie was a very gentle, playful beast. She was 11 years old, 2 years older than Bob, and she weighed, so the keeper said, nearly 2 tons. When Bob went into the tent and called to her, she would turn round, raise her head, underline the word raise, and trumpet gently, underline the word trumpet. Then when he went up to her, she would put her trunk first into one of his pockets and then into the other, in search of the small sugary buns which his mother made. You may be sure that there were nearly always a few buns in Bob's pocket for his greatest friend. Sometimes, to have a game with Cassie, Bob would hide the buns under his jersey or in his school bag. Yet even tricks, underline the word tricks, of that kind could not put Cassie off. If her trunk could find no buns in his pocket, it rolled up his jersey in search of them. Now class, come to the next page, page number 26. If they were not there, the trunk would swing, underline the word swing, gently about until it found the school bag. Then, before you could say bun, Cassie would have the bag open and the buns in her mouth. There never was a more curious beast, declared her keeper. She pokes, underline the word poke, that trunk of hers into everything, and she never rests until she has found what she is looking for, underline the word look for. Now come to the next part on page number 27. One day the tent where the animals lived had to be taken down, underline the word take down, for some repairs. The horses were lodged, underline the word lodge, for the night in some stables in the town. Bongo and Cassie to Bob's delight, were stabled in a shed. Underline the word shed. In a joiner's yard, next door to Bob's home. Bob went to say good night to Cassie and to take her a bun or two before he went to bed. I'll see you in the morning, old lady, he said, and he reached up to stroke, underline the word stroke, her great ear. The next morning, before daylight, Bob's mother was awakened by a loud crash downstairs in the kitchen. She sat up in bed and listened. What could it be? Burglars. Underline the word burglars. Class, come to the next page, page number 29. Crash, crash, again louder than the first time. Mrs. White and Bob were the only people in the house, and Bob was asleep. Mrs. White was very much afraid, but she felt that she must go and find out what the noise was. She went softly downstairs and opened the door that led, underline the word led, into the kitchen. As she did so, something long and gray waved in her face, underline the word wave in. It was an elephant's trunk. The owner of the trunk was standing wedged, underline the word wedge, in the narrow doorway leading into the back garden. Mrs. White ran upstairs again, calling Bob, there's a great beast in the kitchen, and I believe it's your elephant. Bob was awake and downstairs in 3 minutes. Cassie was still in the doorway, trying with her trunk to open a cupboard door which was locked. Cups, plates and saucers which had been set out, underline the word set out, on the table for the morning's breakfast were lying in pieces on the floor. For Cassie had pulled off, underline the word pull off, the tablecloth and had tried to eat half of it. She had also swept jugs and dishes from the dresser onto the floor. Oh, Cassie, cried Bob, what are you doing here? Go back at once. Underline the word at once. Class, come to the next page, page number 30. At the sound of a voice that she knew, Cassie began to back out of the doorway. She did not find it easy to do this, for she was really rather tightly wedged. Still, she freed herself at last. Then she let Bob take her by the trunk and lead her out of the garden gate. She had broken the gate open by leaning against it, just as she had broken open the kitchen door and the door of her stable. Chains and bound her feet to the stable floor by she had snapped them. Underline the word snap. Bob led Cassie back into the shed where she stayed quietly while he roused. Underline the word rose. Her keeper and some more men who soon made her secure again. Underline the word secure. Didn't I tell you, the keeper said to Bob later in the day, that there never was a more curious beast. She wants to find out all about everything, and that's why she took a trip as far as your kitchen, I suppose. Was that it? Bob whispered, underline the word whisper, to Cassie as he leaned, underline the word lean, against her and patted her thick hide. What did you come to look for in our kitchen, old lady? Cassie lifted her head and gave a soft little. Class, come to the last page, page number 31. trumpet and Bob was sure that she said buns of course. What do you think? Assalamu alaikum.